For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales First Quarter 2008-3 from your Sample Files folder. You'll often want to summarize information from multiple worksheets within a workbook. We want to summarize the January, February, and March sales on the summary worksheet. This involves using cross-worksheet formulas. A cross-worksheet formula prefixes the cell reference with the worksheet name followed by an exclamation mark. Before I can summarize sales, I'm going to need totals in my January, February, and March worksheets. Let's begin with the January worksheet. So I'll click on the January worksheet tab and then press Control End to move to the end of the worksheet. I'll now add the word total in cell G87. So I'll click in cell G87 and type total followed by the Enter key. Now I think I'd like to align the text total to the right of cell G87. So I'll click in cell G87 and click Home on the ribbon and in the alignment group, Right Align. I want totals for both the units and the cash value of sales. So I'll click in cell H87 and I'll use the skill you learned in lesson 2-3 to quickly add a total. I click Home on the ribbon, Editing Group and click twice on Auto Sum. And now I'll use the same technique to add total cash sales value to cell J87. That's a double click on the Auto Sum button again. And for appearance's sake, I think I'll boldface all of row 87. So I'll click on the row 87 row header to select the entire row and then click Home on the ribbon and in the font group, the Bold button. Now I'll do the same for February and March. That's February worksheet tab, Control End to move to the end, double click Auto Sum for the total of column J, click at the bottom of column H and do the same thing, the word total, and I want to right align that in the cell, and I also want to boldface all of row 81. Now the March worksheet. I click on the March worksheet tab, Control End to move to the end of the worksheet, an auto sum at the bottom of column J, an auto sum at the bottom of column H, the word total. In cell G79, I want to right align the word total and I want to boldface all of row 79. Now that I have my totals in place, I can summarize them on the summary worksheet. So I'll click on the summary worksheet and I think I'll begin by adding a title to cell A1. And I think a good title would be First Quarter Summary. Now I'll make this a little more attractive by applying the title style. You learnt how to do this in lesson 4-9. I click on cell A1, Home tab on the ribbon, Styles group, Cell Styles, and the title style from the Cell Styles gallery. Now I'll add column headers in cells A3, B3 and C3. I'll click in cell A3 and my first column header can be month. I'll press the tab key. My next column header can be units, tab key, and my final column header can be price. Now I'll add the month names Jan, Feb and March in cells A4, A5 and A6 using the autofill skills you learned in session 2. I click in cell A4 and type Jan and I'll hover the mouse cursor over the autofill handle on the bottom right corner of the selected cell. Then I click and drag down to cell A6 and Jan, Feb, Mar appear in the three cells. Now let's add a style to the column headers. I'll select cells A3 to C3, Home tab on the ribbon, Styles and the Cell Styles gallery, and I think the Heading 2 style would look good here. And let's add a style to January, February and March as well. Once again, the Cell Styles gallery. And this time I think I'll use the Heading 4 style. Now it's time to add those cross-worksheet formulas to put the correct totals in cells B4 to C6. So let's begin with the January units. I'll click in cell B4 and type equals on the keyboard. Then I'll click on the January worksheet, click on the units total cell, and press the Enter key. Now I'll do the same for February. Equals on the keyboard, February worksheet, total units, Enter. And March. Equals on the keyboard, March worksheet, total units, and Enter. Now let's do the same for the cash value. In cell C4, equals on the keyboard, it's the January worksheet, and the total value, and Enter. For February, equals on the keyboard, February worksheet, and the total value, and Enter key. And for March, equals on the keyboard, the March worksheet, click on the total value, press the Enter key. Let's now look at the formulas that have been created behind these cells. I'll move the active cell to cell B4 and look at the formula bar at the top of the screen. And you can see that the formula is equals January exclamation mark H87. And I'm sure that you can guess that this means return the value in cell H87 on the January worksheet. And you can see that the formulas for the other cells have been constructed in exactly the same way. I'd now like to say just a few words on naming worksheets. Because if instead of January, you'd named the January worksheet January Sales, you'd have to refer to it using the formula equals open quotation mark January space sales close quotation mark exclamation mark and then the cell reference. This involves a little extra work. So many Excel users avoid using worksheet names that have spaces in them. If you really do need more than one word to describe a worksheet, it's a good idea to not leave a space between the words and to separate the words by using capital letters, like this, January, no space, sales. So now that you understand the benefits of not having spaces in worksheet names, I'll remove column F just to keep things tidy. I think the formatting in cells B4 to C6 leaves a little to be desired. For the prices, it would be nice to have a comma separator for the thousands and two decimal places. And you learnt in lesson 4.3 that the comma style is ideal for this. I'll select cells C4 to C6, then click Home tab on the ribbon, and in the number group, the comma style. For the units, it would be nice to have the comma after the thousands, but of course, I don't want two decimal places. For this, the comma zero style is ideal. I'll select cells B4 to B6, and to select the comma zero style, you need to bring up the cell styles gallery. So that's home on the ribbon, styles, and cell styles, and you can see the comma zero style at the bottom. I'll click comma zero, and that looks a lot better. You now have a very effective summary sheet summarizing sales in January, February, and March. And all that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales First Quarter 2008 4. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 6.6, Create Cross-Worksheet Formulas.